Hello, this is Mike Sayers from Mechanical Simulation. Welcome to part 3 in our video series on ADAS applications. This one will talk about how we animate pedestrians, as you're seeing here, bicycles and animals. We'll start with the pedestrians crossing the road. In this case, we're going to use the same library screen that we did in the previous video showing a stop sign where we had global X and Y coordinates in a fixed position. In this time, we're going to specify a path and a road, use S and L coordinates to locate the initial position of the object, use the option here to have the moving object, which is our pedestrian, go 90 degrees relative to the path. We specify a speed and a starting condition and a stopping condition for the speeds. Now, to see how those go into the math model, we'll take a look at the echo file. First, let me point out that we have a symbol stack variable again here, O. In this case, the pedestrian is object number 2, so we look down here for things affecting object 2. We have a condition for starting, which is when the station is greater than minus 15, like we saw over here. We stop when the lateral coordinate is greater than 9. That's what we see here. The conditions are used up in an equation for the speed. If the start condition is true and the stop condition has not happened yet, then here is our speed. Otherwise, it's 0. And the speed was set over here as being 4 over 3.6. That's to get 4 kilometers per hour converted to meters per second. Let's take a look at how this works in our animation. Both pedestrians are standing in a natural stance. When the car gets to the prescribed point, the woman walks first, then the man goes. They're both walking at different speeds, but their feet are contacting the ground. They're not slipping and sliding. And then when they get to the stopping location, they stop and they resume their neutral stance. We'll go down to this link and see how we set up the animation for the female pedestrian. You see, this is a group because we have to specify the pedestrian twice, once waiting and once walking. Here's the waiting version. It's a reference frame data set for the visualizer where we specify the names of output variables that are used to locate the shape in space. We need X, Y, Z coordinates and possibly yaw, pitch, and roll angles. In this case, we're using the variables associated with the moving object. We use the symbol stack here so that it will apply for any of them. In this case, it's going to be used for object 2, which is the woman, and object 3, which is the male. The shape is real straightforward. It's just a standing person. But the dynamic thing in here is that we have a variable that determines whether the shape is visible or not. We have the speed of object 2 here, and it's got a tilde in front of it. That's a Boolean not. So if the speed is 0, then not 0 is 1, and that would cause the shape to be shown. If the speed is anything else, the not of it will be 0 and the shape would be hidden. We go to the other side. We have the same variables up here showing position and orientation. This time we use VOBJ as the formula for visibility. If the speed is anything other than 0, it's visible. Now how do we get the moving limbs? It's in the shape itself. This is what it looks like with our in our visualizer without doing anything else. Now from the title up here, you can see that it's set up for her to be going 5 kilometers per hour. If we have her going faster than that, her feet would slide, or if they're going slower. So we have a function, or we have a command in the visualizer to set a time ratio here. Time for the animation is going to be the real time multiplied by this ratio. So if the speed is higher than 5, the time is going to speed it up so her legs will move faster. If the speed is lower than 5 kilometers per hour, they will be slowed down accordingly. This is the data set for the man. It's very similar except that his initial location is a little bit different, so he's not coinciding with the other pedestrian. And his speed is a little bit higher, so we saw him overtake her. If we want to have crossing animals, we use the same methods, but our animator shapefiles are for animals instead of humans. And what about bicyclists? In this example, we have two. The first one is leading. She turns and leans into the turn, the second one goes in a straight line. Here is the second bicyclist who's going straight, and it's fairly simple to set up. We're setting a type up here using symbol stack. We've got lots of symbol stack variables that are here. In fact, almost everything is set this way, and I'll explain why in a minute. For the animation, we go to a shape, and we'll look at this with the visualizer. And we see the visualizer has done all, or our art team has done all the work. It shows the person pedaling. And given that bikes have gears, we really don't have to change the cadence of the pedaling to match the speed. We can just live with this for everything. Now, going back to the data set that uses the bicycle, this is where we set values for all these symbol stack variables. The reason that we do this is that this data set that has the bicyclists will follow the path, go anywhere. We just have to set all these conditions, and we can use the same data set in many scenarios. The other one, where the rider is leading into the turn, is a little bit more complicated. It's got some equations up here. And we'll take a quick look at the echo file because they're easier to read here. The one that leads into the turn is object 4. We would like the roll angle of the bike to be in equilibrium with a centrifugal force from following the curve at a given speed. And the way to do that is to take the curvature times v squared, meters per second squared, divided by g to normalize it, and then take the arctangent, and that's the roll angle. Now, we did that in an example you're not seeing, and it's a very abrupt change because the path goes from straight to pure arc to straight. So we throw in a low-pass filter here. Instead of setting the roll directly, we set the derivative of roll to be the thing that we calculated minus what the current roll is, and then we divide by 2, which is the time constant that corresponds to a half a hertz low-pass filter. And that's the end of our video. We've shown you a lot of content, but don't worry. We have documentation for all the screens that we've used and some tech memos giving examples. And the examples we've looked at are installed in CarSim, TruckSim, and BikeSim. Thank you for watching.